Greetings all, welcome to my video. Canadian food guide shifts from meat and dairy to a whole foods plant-based recommendation. By Arjun Walia. The facts. Canada has announced the implementation of a new food guide, one that promotes a whole foods, plant-based diet, with the elimination of dairy, and processed meats, as well as a reduction in the consumption of meat. Reflect on. With all of the science, and documented examples, showing that the human body is more adapted to a whole foods, plant-based diet, why is it so hard for people to believe? Who has been influencing our thoughts about our diet for all of these years? The world is quickly changing, and it's changing for the better. It's incredible to see just how much the consciousness of the planet has shifted in so many different areas, including the food industry. At the same time, the more the world continues to wake up, the harsher the reaction from the opposition. It's hard to challenge false belief systems that humanity has held onto for so long. The most recent example of this shift in consciousness comes from Canada, one of multiple countries now encouraging a whole foods, plant-based diet. Why? It's a lot healthier, and the science proves it. Can you believe our old food guide actually recommended processed meats and dairy? We'll discuss that more later, but for now let's focus on the new food guide. This is a dramatic change for Canada. As Global News points out, the guide is one of the federal government's most requested publications, with its influence felt in doctors' offices, school cafeterias, hospitals, and home kitchens across the country. And for the past four decades, the guide has looked more or less the same, telling Canadians to eat a diet of specific servings from four food groups, but the new guide unveiled on Tuesday, the first major update in more than 12 years, radically upends this formula. It no longer has separate meat and dairy categories, or four distinct food groups at all. Also gone are serving sizes and numbers. Instead, Health Canada has chosen a simpler approach. The new guide shows an image of a plate, half of it covered with fruits and vegetables. The other half is divided into whole grains and proteins, a new category that contains meat, dairy, and plant-based foods, such as chickpeas and tofu. Our education regarding food has been extremely misleading, and that's largely because it's heavily funded by major food corporations. So why the switch now? It's likely because the population has had a shift in consciousness, and the government had to make a shift in order to reflect these changes. We've seen the same thing with unidentified flying objects, and we will begin to see it with many other topics as well. It's also a positive step, because eating meat and consuming dairy products is simply not sustainable for the planet. For example, approximately 90% of Amazon rainforest destruction is due to grazing animals. Most of that is to support the high demand of the meat and dairy industries. If you can believe it, we clear out an entire football field worth of forests every single second. You can find sources in the articles linked below. Today, close to 100 plant, animal, and insect species are lost because of meat and dairy farming. Here we are with all of our focus on CO2, when animal agriculture produces more greenhouse gases than all of the transportation industries combined. Meat accounts for a shocking 51% of global greenhouse gases. This is a huge issue that needs to be addressed, but instead, it's been swept under the rug for years. Not only are the meat and dairy industries destroying our planet, but consuming these products also causes multiple chronic health ailments and diseases. Think about it, consuming another animal's breast milk just doesn't seem normal. We are the only animal on the planet who drinks the milk of another animal. We are the only animal on the planet who drinks milk after weaning, and continue to do so well into adulthood. Big Food has used calcium as a marketing scam to justify consuming cow's milk, but if you look at the science, drinking milk from a cow has led to weaker bones and higher risk of osteoporosis. In fact, animal protein creates a condition within the body called metabolic acidosis, which sucks out calcium from the bones. You cannot in fact, absorb calcium without equal parts magnesium, which milk does not provide. There is a reason why most of the world is lactose intolerant, because we actually had to develop and evolve the enzyme to be able to digest the milk of a cow. Sources linked below. It's become quite clear that we can't really trust our regulatory agencies. The FDA protects the big drug companies and are subsequently rewarded, and using the government's police powers, they attack those who threaten the big drug companies. People think that the FDA is protecting them. It isn't. What the FDA is doing, and what the public thinks it is doing, are as different as night and day, said Dr. Herbert Leonard Lay Jr., 10th Commissioner, and head of the FDA. The takeaway. There is still a long way to go, until our global food system is healed, including the GMO, pesticide issue, that also plagues our planet, and our health. It's interesting to reflect on the government's intentions behind shifting our food guide. Is it really rooted in health, which it wasn't in the past, or is it still all about money? The previous food guide has made it abundantly clear that we cannot trust the government to look out for our health, and so we must do our own research. Although this is a step in the right direction, it's still not enough. A recent study showed that nearly 10% of the population of Canada now identifies as being vegetarian or vegan. According to research from Dalhousie University, there are 2.3 million vegetarians in Canada, which is up 900,000 from a survey taken 15 years ago, and another 850,000 people identify as vegan. Combined, these numbers add up to 9.4% of the Canadian population. This is forcing restaurants and the meat, egg, and dairy industries to consider new approaches to a dwindling market. At the end of the day, we have to acknowledge the health and environmental benefits of a meat and dairy-free diet, and either cut these products out completely, or at least reduce our consumption of them. It's not healthy, and it's unsustainable, and that really can't be argued anymore. Veganism is a very fine form of nutrition. It's a little extreme to tell a person who is using flesh foods that you're going to take everything entirely away from them. When I was in practice in medicine, I would tell the patients that the vegetable-based diet was the healthy way to go, and to keep away from the animal products as much as possible. People are very sensitive about what they eat. You can talk to people about exercising, relaxation, good mental attitude, and they will accept that. But you talk to them about what they are eating, and people are very sensitive about that. If an individual is willing to listen, I will try to explain to them on a scientific basis of how I think it's better for them, from Dr. Ellsworth Wareham, heart surgeon. Note, EarthStar is not trying to get you to change your diet. What and how you eat is your choice. I myself am not a vegetarian or vegan. Thank you for watching. Please help spread the word and make a difference by sharing and subscribing for more thought-provoking content, and give us a thumbs up if you liked the video. Your support is greatly appreciated. Be aware and stay safe.